Howdy folks, and welcome back once more to Let's Play Pool of Radiance. Today, we're maybe going to poke around in the Temple of Bane? I do have the map of the town here, so it looks like to get there, you want to come in from the north? Go to the city? It is Cobble Mansion. So from here we want to go south. And that'll get us to the Wealthy District, and then from the Wealthy District we want to go west. We do have to explore the Wealthy District yet. So I'm actually going to come here. I'm going to save. I don't want to quit. And I think we can rest here, right? Yes, okay. So, restore spells, fix. Alright. There we go. Alright, we surprised somebody. I'm just going to flee. I have no idea what that was. We spot a group of orcs. Not too interested. Four orcs whose shields bear a black hand on a red field. They cautiously look you over. They ready their spears. Flee! I get fucked, kids. Alright, so this is the temple? Yeah, wealthy area / Temple of Bane. Alright. Well, we are not gonna do that yet. I wanna poke around here first. We spot a group of goblins. Again with the orcs. A big damn room. About a group of goblins. I should probably be picking these fights, but it's like, it's four orcs. It's not, like, that's not gonna be worth any XP. It's just going to be a waste of time. Really, I'm just looking for encounters. Just, basically any loot. Like, I would like to get some XP. Oh, we are surprised by goblins. How unfortunate for them. I really should have Rove memorized Burning Hands or something. Just to get, like, some AoE. Although I guess we do have the front row. Swell, you hit a goblin and you didn't kill it, man. Come on. Move here. Excuse me. Let's see. Swell. Step here. Again! He did it again! Not even Rove could kill that one. Durton! Just disappointment. Just so much disappointment. Devon. Aww, Devon, you could have done a pro move, but you didn't. Instead, you failed. Hey. Have Goldleaf come in. Nice. Swell. Devon. I should have had him step one more square to the north. He would have been able to hit all three then. Oh well. Wow, we actually took some damage. Chunk took 4 damage. Oh wow, 36 experience points. Let's spend it all in one place. Durton, are you stealing my XP? I bet you are, you son of a bitch. The other reason that I didn't want to have, like, hirelings in the party, because they leech XP. And we can't carry them into further games. You can, you can steal gear off of them, though. Like, if I recall correctly, they're, like, fighters and stuff you can hire in taverns, and they have, like, magical gear, and you can take it. Speaking of magical gear, Brunhilde items. Yeah, I was gonna say, I thought I forgot to equip the +3 versus undead sword. I did. So I'm curious, this map has an exit out to the south, but according to Ye Olde City map, like, that's the river. So I don't know. Stand outside a large mansion. On the walls of the mansion are crude black handprints. Alright. You enter into a filthy room, 8 orc guards immediately attack you. Okay. Allow us to introduce ourselves. So anyway, Swell started swinging. Even Durton's getting in on it. Chunk, disappointed in you. Brunhilda's got it though. Goldleaf, step down here. I just want her in the this other orc leader's grill so that he doesn't shoot Rove with an arrow. Okay. Oh, you could have killed him. Thankfully, Devon happened. Alright. Wasn't too bad. 29 XP. No loot that I give a shit about. So this is like a little guard room. Cute. Wonder if we can rest. We might be able to rest in there. About a group of goblins. They stand ready. I don't care. You enter into a room that has been converted into a cell. On the wall here is a poorly scratched out message. You can barely make out the words North Wall, right in front of glass, southeast, maybe? Okay. Again, these orcs. It's nice that the game seems to be pretty. See, you enter in a room that has some crude hay beds. What'll you do? Search them. Uh-oh. As you search the bed, a group of orcs comes in through the doorway. Oh no! Victims! Well, yeah, about that. Let's just have Chunk move around back here. Durton, Delay, Devon. They're killing stuff. Jesus. Feels good, man. I will say that. You finish searching the beds, but you find nothing but lice and hair. There's a group of goblins just napping in the corner or something. I don't know. Video games. You guys, like, I'm not gonna fight your, like, random trash mob parties. Rove's getting near a level, but he ain't that near a level. He's maybe, I don't know, 75%, 80% there. Like I said, looking for treasure. Like, Christ on a cracker. So many critter beasts. I wonder, again, like, I wonder if it's because I have search on that encounters are happening so readily. I'm not fighting the Black Hand Orcs. Oh my lord! It's like, look at this! Literally taking a step and being attacked. As you enter the building, you see a large group of foul orcs. They snarl and move to attack. Okay. Let's go ahead and just take out most of these. And if Devon goes, I'm probably gonna take out even more. Alright, I want Devon right here, and I want him to cast sleep as well. And I want him to drop that, like, right here. My god, there's going to be one orc awake, and the rest of these things are just sleeping. Alright, I'm just gonna turn on quick combat. Seriously? Don't cast spells, you assholes. Just kill them. Oh god, they're equipping bows and shit. There, alright, now it's. Was it Control Alt? There we go. Alright, nice and done. I'm sure that sound is like. I shouldn't say that's horrible for headphone users. I am a headphone user and it is unpleasant, but. The time is saved. Oh, we're surprised by more orcs. Oh my lord. just cannot catch a break. Rove is just soaking up the experience points, though. Oh, Durton took a hit. Hilda, go ahead and swap back over to your magical undead slaying sword. Devon, you don't even have a weapon equipped. Why? Fucking video games, man. How do they work? Swell. Go back your long sword and shield. Chunk, you've got your short sword. Hitting things reliably, which I am thankful for. Rove! Get in there. Mix it up with that dagger. I think Brunhilde come over and assist Chunk. Not that I don't think Chunk can handle three orcs. It's just gonna be quicker with two of them fighting and the rest of the party is dealing with this other mob down here. Durton, you are just bad, man. I don't think he has hit ever. Like, barring attacking things that are unconscious. Alright. Oh, now they're wussing out. Wisely so. Oh my god, I goofed. I had to move on an angle instead of directly down. The experience points we're gonna be missing. God damn. Ugh, petulance. Only 34. That could have been like 36. Son of a bitch. Better reload my last save and, you know, redo the fight, right? I'm gonna save, speaking of which. We're in F. Press F for that experience point that we lost. Before you is a great hall. The floor is littered with orc trash and the walls have crude black hands painted on them. You find a trap door. Will you open it? Yeah, okay. Oh, there's some XP. Nice. Chunk actually leveled from that. Gold leaf? Oh, we can't. Cleric scroll potion ring. Really? Ooh. Alright, Chunk, that was probably a thief level, if I had to guess. No, fighter, nice. 5 more hit points and his stack improved. He's now a 4th level fighter. Sweet! You are in the remains of a great dining room. Furniture lies burned and broken throughout it. Underneath a broken table, you find a crushed skeleton. It has some jewelry on it. Take it? Yeah, sure. Holy shit, this XP! 942. It does, yeah, Durton is totally gaining XP. Interesting. I'll take it all. Alright, Devon actually leveled from that. Another fighter level. Alright, sure. That's getting him some extra hit points. Here, update the list there. 25. Rove, probably at about 95%. I'm gonna go ahead and save. Durton, I assume he's going to leave once we're done with quests. You're in a room filled with rubble and waste. In the rubble, you spot a beautiful tapestry. Take it? Sure. Aw, no XP for this one. And it's just a tapestry. We'll leave it. Not so much interested in the tapestry or the gold. Uh-oh. As you enter the room, you see 6 orcs led by an ogre. Alright. I really, really wish that I had slept. But I don't think that we have found a place where it would be safe to do so yet. Where's Swell? Okay, I killed that one. My hope is that Swell will be able to get that. Ooh, old person. Swell, move. Get in on that ogre. Devon, you too. Goldleaf, look busy. All right, let's hold some orcs. Nice, got 2 of them. That works for me. Mostly because the AI is too stupid to move around them. The gold leaf can hold that line. Ogres down, orcs down, orcs down, and the fight is won. That wasn't too bad. 42 experience points. damn, don't spend it all in one place. You find a piece of paper on the floor in the room. You place it in your journal under entry 53.
Ah.
53, a crumpled, discarded piece of paper full of rub-outs and scratch-overs. Priests, 1. Acolytes, 4. Ogres, 1. Hobgoblins, 40. Orcs, 90. Goblin slaves, 20. That's probably troops that they've brought in, if I had to guess. So my hope is that this room is safe to sleep in. About a group of goblins, oh my lord. In camp. Save. Not quit. Okay, I'm gonna freaking memorize spells. No, she's got all of her spells. Really? Oh, here. Cast a Cure Light Wounds. Just hit yourself with it. I apparently forgot to re-memorize Detect Magic on Goldleaf. I was wondering why she couldn't cast it. Javon, you need, I believe, another sleep. Rove, do 2 sleeps and a Burning Hands. I'm curious to see how Burning Hands works. And second level, that is your Stinking Cloud. Yes. Rest. Ah, and we were interrupted. Attacked by orcs, who've made their last worst choice. And don't even get any spells! Son of a bitch! I just want my frickin' Burning Hands spell. We have Durton coming up here purely so that the orcs don't move and beat the shit out of Rogue. Not that I'm really particularly worried about him, I guess. With how brazenly I'm having him just run around and attack things, but... what is that orc even doing? He could have just stepped down and beat on the wizard. But apparently... oh my god, Durton hit something! Oh, Frabj's day. Nice. Come up here. Guard. I assume this other orc's gonna... wow, it's actually not fleeing. So it just charged in a chunk and was immediately cut down. Okay, so if I try to rest, am I gonna have to re-memorize all of my fucking spells again? Of course! Oh, video games. I'm not going to DOS. Oh, I cannot wait to get to Curse of the Azure Bonds where they actually remember your fucking spells. You're in a room that is filled with the dead body of the orc's previous victims. Amidst the bodies, you find some jewelry. Take it? You betcha, and that is why. Jewelry is good XP. We'd be getting more if we didn't have a fucking extra cleric in the party. The bastard. He's actually, like, in the time he's been with us, he's, like, probably 60% towards the next level now. It's crazy. Fuck off, orcs. I'm poking around. In this room are some goblin slaves that are cowering in the corner. They all scream, "Please don't kill us." What will you do? Well, let them go. As they leave, one of them says, "To enter the temple, you need a holy symbol of Bane." Alright, I was told about those. Those are the leather holy symbols that we found in Podal Plaza, so we can probably go back and grab one of those at some point. Again, it's like you take a step and it's ready for battle. I don't know, this area has been very lucrative. So I can't bitch too much. Fucking knock spells, I swear to god. I wish I could knock enemies and it would just like turn them inside out or something. That'd be cool. But no. Wizards don't get nice things like that. Durton. Yeah, you can't really do too much, can you, buddy? Where's Goldleaf? Alright, Goldleaf's actually right next to him. I'm gonna have him cast Cure Wounds on her. There we go. I think he healed her for 2. Very impressive. Asset to the team. Do it again. one that time. Holy shit. God almighty. Healing is so bad in D&D. It is just so bad. It was bad in the old editions, it's bad in the new editions, it's just not worth the actions in combat. It's just, it's terrible. That was a little bit better. Not amazing, but a little bit better. Alright. But yeah, like, basically the only hit point healing spell worth casting in most editions of D&D is heal. Purely because it heals enough that it will, like, negate, you know, a round's worth of actions, assuming whoever you're casting it on survived whatever was beating the hell out of them. Okay, I'd say we've pretty much explored this, so we're gonna leave. We are going to encamp, and we've gotta rememorize all of our spells. Because funsies! Yes, memorize. Sleep, yes, memorize. Sleep. Fuego. Stinking Cloud. Alright. Dirtin' here. My little healing battery. Second level. I'm gonna give him a couple Hold Person spells. Hold Person's a good spell. Animate Dead, I doubt, is worth much of anything. Prayer, though, is okay. Alright. Yes, memorize. Everybody rest. Okay. Store spells. And camp fix. There we go. Alright, so we need a Holy Symbol of Bane, which is a trip back to Podal Plaza. Which we can get to from the west side of town. Let's just come over here, maybe? The north entrance and a south entrance, maybe... south? Oh god. The textile house, we fear that. What's the north? Okay, so the north entrance on the west side is Podal Plaza. Okay, we're learning things. Oh my god. Ugh, hobgoblins, why? Like, I just do not care. Again, we just need fireball. Rove's got scrolls, but I'm saving them. Curious about Burning Hands. I'm gonna wait until the fight's a little bit more condensed, and then we're gonna see about maybe torching some of these assholes. Maybe. I don't know. I don't know what the AoE is of a Burning Hands. I don't know if it's an actual cone like it is in Tabletop, or if it's just gonna be like a single target spell and I'm gonna be very, very disappointed. I don't know. We'll see. Oh, I see a group, that 2x2 group of them. Oh yeah, that group at the bottom is gonna get introduced to some fuego, I think. Durton, hold the line. Okay, so step here, cast Burning Hands. Like this. It's a single target spell, and it did 4 points of damage. Mother of God, why? Why would you ever cast that? Ugh. Like, even if it were a 2x2 that did, like, a d4, like, sure. That's useful when you're, like, Babby-level adventurers. Cast Sleep. I'm gonna cast Sleep. You get a bunch of these guys. Okay, so now we know at least that Burning Hands is not worth memorizing. Disappointing though it is. Like, why would you ever cast Burning Hands instead of Magic Missile. Like, Magic Missile is just far and away superior. I got nothing. Fucking video games. ...61 XP. Rove is, like, right there! Oh my lord. Oh my fucking god. Right here? Yes! Oh no. Oh no, the Banites have gone! Uh-oh. I'm sure that there's somewhere else for us to find... holy symbol. Actually, I wonder... We might just be able to... Oh my god, 21 orcs. You know what? No. How about this? Like, let's just reload. And we'll save ourselves the fucking bullshit of that. I just... Holy shit. Like, that is a slog and a half of a fight. Load, and we are on F. Okay, we are on F. Search for our thing. Alright, no, I do not want to leave a map note. Nope. With that. Okay. So this is... We've done everything. We need to go back and memorize our spells. I thought I saved after I did that. I'm gonna flip search off. If that maybe lets us maneuver a little bit easier. Seems like it. Okay, so, in camp. Memorize. Detect magic. Yes. Devon. Sleep. Rove. Just sleep. Yeah, three sleep spells. And stinking cloud, Dirtin, all the healing, whole person, and I'm gonna get animate dead. I just want to see if it does anything. Like, if it's actually worth anything. I assume it's probably not, but you never know. All right, so fix, store spells, save, do not quit. All right. So now, from here, we want to go to the west. Group of hobgoblins! Oh my god. Like, this is one of those, like... These are fights that... like, you're never gonna have stuff like this in a tabletop game. I mean, unless your DM is just, like, wasting everybody's time, I guess. Because it's like, alright, hobgoblins, like, are... like, no threat to this party. So, like, if you've got sense about you, you'll just either hand wave and, like, if you roll an attack against, you know, 1d12 hobgoblins, you're just gonna be like, okay, that doesn't happen, and you guys proceed, and, you know, it's smooth sailing. Or, like, if you want to get your violence on, you can be like, yeah, you bump into a group of hobgoblins and just easily kill them because they're literally no threat! Ah, but not so much in Gold Box. Here we have to suffer through this shit. Do not attack Swell, he's done nothing wrong. Dirtin hit something again, that's twice in one episode. I think we're lucky. Rove looked busy. Alright. Okay, no. Exit. Just want to get to the exit. It's painful. What's the range on Fireball? I want to say that Fireball has a smaller AoE if you're outdoors. Like, my temptation to use a Scroll of Fireball and just blow these fucking things up is strong. But I probably shouldn't. Because I think indoors Fireball is like a 3x3 area. But outdoors, I think it's 2x2? We'll see. There will be experimentation once we can actually cast Fireball. I was hoping to like start poking around in the Temple of Bane, but I have a feeling after this fight I'm gonna go ahead and call it. Rove will ideally hit 5th level next time, and then the fuego begins. Devon is like a year and a half away from gaining levels, but he tries really hard and believes. So I guess, actually here, let's cast Animate Dead. Let's see what we can summon. Maybe we'll get like a wraith or something. More realistically, I expect it's going to be a skeleton or a zombie. Animate Dead is not a great spell. Rove, run interception. Oh, did he? I think he summoned something? Did he? Yes? No? No. So apparently we can't reanimate orcs. We have to animate dead party members. Animate Dead is, in fact, as disappointing as I was expecting it to be. What is this frickin' orc doing? It's like moving around to flank Devon or something, maybe? Yeah, how'd that work out for you, buddy? He's got an 1890 strength score. Dude doesn't play. He's a fucking failboat, but if he hits you, you're dead. I think an 1890 strength is like plus 4 to damage or something. It's absurd. My god, Durton just trading blows back and forth. Chunk fighting off 5 of these things. Angriest little dwarf. Bam. That wasn't too bad. Just a little bit of a slog there. Okay. Ah. Blessed progression. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and save, and I think I'm going to go ahead and call it here. So, as usual, folks, thank you for watching. Hope you all had a good time, and I will see you all next time we're in further adventure. Until then. Hey, you made it to the end. Nice. If you had a good time, check out one of these other series, see if you like them. Drop a like, comment, or subscribe if you'd like to support the channel, via the machine and all that. As always, thanks for watching!